The Herzliya conference kicked off in Israel today with senior politicians, military officials, and analysts taking part. But one person in particular stole the show today, President Reuven Rivlin, who has become an unlikely voice in support of reconciliation. Eli Hochenberg, diplomatic correspondent for the News Today, has more.
Israeli leaders from across the political spectrum expressed yet again their thoughts on the two-state solution in what was supposed to be the focus of the first day of the prestigious Herzliya conference. Yet the spotlight was stolen by one individual who chose not to discuss the controversial and divisive issue, but rather unity.
Israeli society is changing. It's not just a simple change, but a transformation that will reshape our identity and, as such, will have a profound effect on the way we understand ourselves and our national home. We cannot escape this change.
President Rivlin summarized his first year in the post, which many thought would be much more difficult coming in the wake of the term of the widely admired Shimon Peres. Yet 12 months later, the once under-the-radar Rivlin has become a beloved character whose message of reconciliation has transformed the discourse from one of despair into optimism.
In order to create hope, you must know the facts. Ignoring the facts, denying them, repressing them, the inability to see those changed will do no good.
Rivlin did not sugarcoat reality, nor did he spare the Israeli public from criticism. He called for a national soul-searching, for a wake-up call.
Repression or struggle will not assist. All of us, ultra-Orthodox, secular, religious, and Arabs, we are all here to stay. Now, if we really want to deal with the meaning of the new Israeli order, then we must bravely look straight into it and ask the tough questions.
But the question remains, is Israel prepared to tackle not only external threats, but internal ones as well? Is the country ready to face its own demons alongside those attacking it from the outside? One thing is for certain, for as long as Ruvi Rivlin is president, he will force the nation to address these questions.